Hi, I'm Ed Fulbright, CPA, CGMA, PFS, a Fulbright Financial Consulting PA. We would like to welcome you to our educational briefing.
In a week in which American democracy confronted a major political crisis, the stock market barely blinked. The Justice Department appointed a special counsel to investigate ties between President Trump's campaign and Russia, and troubling leaks sprang from the White House at a breathtaking pace. Yet, the value of America's largest companies barely budged. Why? Why are stocks still hovering near an all-time high? The main reason, and the one most often overlooked, is that America really is exceptional. In the face of a major political crisis, the U.S. government works. The U.S. Constitution, an abundance of resources, and private institutions have a history of making America resilient and create a foundation for stability. Amid the torrent of ill winds, stock prices, a daily barometer of American success after a hiccup, recovered. Meanwhile, new reports showed the economy was continuing to grow. The U.S. Index of Leading Economic Indicators gained 0.3% in April, yet another uptick in a long string of positive monthly reports. The Conference Board, a private business group that tracks the LEI, said the positive consumer outlook points to a growing economy. Keep in mind, historically, this key forward-looking indicator has dropped definitively before recessions, and nothing like that is happening now. Ironically, the strength of stock prices in the face of the circus in Washington could make you concerned that stock prices have lost touch with reality and are being kept aloft by a bubble mentality. But stock market arithmetic indicates that investors are being totally rational. Professor Jeremy Siegel, in his seminal book, Stocks for the Long Run, calculated the compound growth rate of stocks back to 1871 at 9.5% a year, if dividends are included, which is shown in this curved red line. Excluding the reinvestment of dividends, the compound annual growth on stocks is 7.3%, which is shown in the black curved line. While the actual price of the Standard & Poor's 500 stock index, shown with and without dividends by the jagged lines, does not track exactly with the compound annual growth rate, share prices are right in line with their long-term historical performance. If we were in a bubble, you'd see the separation in the curved and jagged lines, like this period here during the tech bubble of the late 1990s. The bottom line is corporate profits, and they have continued to come in stronger than expected. Profits ultimately determine stock prices, and they're being fueled by a strengthening economy and bright outlook for growth. While the circus in Washington is distressing, no matter what your political persuasion, take heart in knowing that the American economy and financial system remain strong and stable.
Thank you for listening. Please contact us with any questions, and also contact us if you're interested in our complimentary second opinion on your investments or to set up a meeting regarding your wealth. Don't hesitate to share this video with people who might benefit from our work. Thank you again, and have a great day.